The Tao of Self-Confidence, episode 700.
Welcome to the Tao of Self-Confidence, where I share stories of amazing women who have discovered their inner journey to self-confidence. Visit our website at thetaoofselfconfidence.com. Your inner journey to self-confidence awaits.
Well, hello, friend. Welcome to the Tao of Self-Confidence, where I share stories of amazing women who have discovered their inner journey to self-confidence. I'm your host today, Sheena Yap Chan, and today I have an amazing lady on the show today. She is a personal brand coach, and I'm really excited to have her on and share her story with us today on self-confidence. So without further ado, I'm going to introduce you to Martine De Luna. Martine, how are you today? Maybe you can fill in a little bit more by yourself to the listeners.
Hey, Sheena, thanks for having me. Yeah, so I'm a personal brand coach. I specifically use a modality called transformational coaching. I'm based over here in the Philippines right now, where I have my family and I serve clients all over the world from home.
Awesome. Well, thanks for sharing that. And Martine, what's your cultural background?
Okay, so I'm Filipino, and I was actually raised as what they call a third culture kid. So we lived in different countries while I was growing up. So that kind of like also gave me this unique element of not having like a high school network and not having, you know, like your usual kind of school experience. So we hopped around a bit. What that gave me, though, was this very like global awareness. So I would say that I kind of think that way too, kind of think outside the box as well. And that's actually kind of the element that I bring to my coaching too, you know, thinking out of the box and helping people to actually, you know, dismiss some of the, or dismantle some of the limiting beliefs that might be holding them back from what they truly desire. So yeah, I'm back in the Philippines raising my family here, but I do work with clients all over the world.
Awesome. Well, thanks for sharing that. And what would be your favorite self-confidence quote?
Self-confidence quote. You are the only solution you will ever have. That's by my mentor, Bob Proctor. Currently at this time, I'm studying his particular modality of coaching. And I love it because people try to look for solutions outside of themselves. They like try to look for other people, situations, but they will only really find solutions to everything that they are going through or that they desire within themselves. So the answer is really self-awareness, personal growth, and your rate of transformation. So that's, I guess, that would also flow into my definition of self-confidence is the more you know who you are, then the more aware of what you can become.
Thanks for sharing that. And I like that definition. It really does have to start with us, right? Especially having more self-awareness. Absolutely. Because without self-awareness, we're not going to know how to solve our problems or solve other people's problems or bring solutions to the table. Absolutely. So thanks for sharing that. And Martine, what was your life like before your discovery of self-confidence?
Well, I really came into coaching, this, you know, this particular kind of mindset coaching in 2016. I had at that point moved out. We had to move out of our home of 5 years because there were some financial, you know, issues that we couldn't handle. Like my husband lost his job. On top of that, I really fell into kind of like a depression. I had just had a baby, and because of that, when you're depressed, when you have a baby, you're depressed and you can't handle things, you drop everything. So what's different with me, though, is the minute I identified that I was depressed, I took a note from this man named Bob Proctor, and he said that very famous quote. He says, you're the only solution to anything you will ever have. So it wasn't just about going to therapy. It wasn't just about, you know, seeking what I could, you know, what I could get out there, but understanding myself. So when I understood, you know, how our mind works and, you know, how much we are conditioned by the people and the things around us, I learned that, well, if I just, you know, learn how to develop new ideas within myself. So using my, what we call the higher faculties, you know, your imagination, your intuition, these things that we forget that we have, then you can really become unstoppable in what you do. So what happened was I was able to get back on my feet. I sought a mentor to help me do that, help me to start a business from the ground up. And also I decided to look into how to coach people. because it was coaches that they weren't the solution to me, but they held the space as I became the solution for myself. So that was my aha moment, as you know, like I was saying, it's like, oh, the more I delve into my transformation, which means I am always, you know, personal growth is number one for me, because your rate of personal transformation and personal growth is the rate of success in your relationships and your income and the impact that you make.
Thanks for sharing that. And, you know, I love how you mentioned, like, you just, you know, you said develop new ideas, because a lot of us feel like we're at this like end of the road and we can't go anywhere else, not realizing, like, you know, we still have the capacity to create something different, create something new if we allow it. And like what you mentioned, right, we can transform at any given moment. So I really love what you mentioned. And, you know, because of these realizations, what's your life been like now?
Well, now, so like I mentioned, I'm still studying, so I'm always studying something. I have a very robust, I'd say, commitment to personal growth, right? So I now am able to run like group coaching programs and masterminds. And the great thing is, like, it's made up of women who were probably on the same path that I was a couple of years back. My mentor always says that a great coach isn't somebody that, you know, accomplished everything that life has thrown to you, but it's just a few steps ahead in terms of how they think about a situation. So I find that I've attracted also women who were in similar situations that I was in. And then I credit that to, you know, God, the universe, allowing me to go through those things and thrive, you know, live through them, survive through them, because they're not for me. The lessons that we have are never just for us. We're never fully satisfied as human beings unless we are growing and contributing. That's a quote from Tony Robbins. He always says that the most successful people aren't those that just look out for themselves, but they seek to grow so that they can contribute to the world. And I think that that is what my life is like now. It is what my life will be until my last breath. And it's what I love. Another quote by my mentor, Bob Proctor, he says, we shouldn't find work. We should do what we love. Work is made for us. We make our work support what we love. So I think I'm going to really be doing this for a long, long time, because I found that as you help other people, as you be available to also hold another person's space and maybe be that guide as they take away their own pain, you will always have something to do, quote unquote, but you will always have a capacity to serve. And when you serve, that is when you are also blessed. You are also taken care of. You are also never without something to do.
Thanks for sharing that. And, you know, to the woman who's listening to your episode, she may be in her own journey to self-confidence. What would be that one tip you would give to her?
I would say, and really, you know, I would have her take it to heart, that embrace responsibility. Like, focus on your responsibility to yourself. You know, most people run from responsibility, and that's why they're, you know, that's why they are where they are. And that can seem, you know, like some harsh advice, but when you really think about it, it all goes back to understanding who we are. When we understand that we are these infinite beings, you know, there's a little bit of woo here, right? But we are. I mean, we are spirits living in a human body, and the key is to understand, you know, what are the most powerful thoughts to think? Because when I have these powerful thoughts, then they create a feeling that I have about myself. You notice how people say, I feel bad, or I feel depressed, or I don't feel good enough. It's all about the feeling. The more you understand who you are, the better and more confident you will feel about yourself. So embrace that responsibility to be your solution, to get self-awareness, to be consciously aware of who you are, because that is what will transform you and give you unshakable confidence.
Thanks for sharing that great tip. And if our listeners wanted to get to know a little bit more about you and what you do and check out some of your work, is there any links or social media profiles we can connect with?
Yeah, sure. So you can find me at my website. That's martinedeluna.com. And I also on Facebook. You can look up Martine De Luna Coaching. I also have a Facebook group that's a lot of fun. I do a lot of Facebook Lives in there. That's called Make It Blissful. And I'm on Instagram from time to time sharing my, you know, the day-to-day life of being a work-at-home mom and coach. That's instagram.com/martinedeluna. I'm also on LinkedIn by the same name, Martine De Luna.
Thanks for sharing that. And to our listeners, if you want to connect with Martine, you can also head on over to thetowelofselfconfidence.com and search for Martine's name. Her show notes will pop up along with everything else that we talked about. And I just really want to thank Martine today for taking the time to share her story and tips with us on self-confidence. So thank you so much, Martine.
Thank you, Sheena.
Not a problem. It was really great having you on the show. And to our listeners, be on the lookout for another new episode of Another Amazing Woman's Journey to Self-Confidence, and we'll talk to you soon. Bye for now.
Thank you for tuning in to another amazing episode of The Tao of Self-Confidence. Want to learn how you can use podcasting to market your business? Download your free report by visiting our website at thetaoofselfconfidence.com. Your inner journey to self-confidence awaits.